Hello everybody, this is Cesar, and in this video I'm going to take you through the different steps that you may follow if you want to record digitally with your Kemper. So it's going to be the Kemper, an audio interface, in this case is the Focusrite 6i6, and Reaper, the software, in order to record in your computer with digital quality. By the way, as the Focusrite 6i6 just arrived, this is why I'm giving away the solo, the Focusrite solo, in the contest. If you want to participate in the contest, you just click on the description section, then it will take you through my video in which I explain the rules for the contest. Basically subscribe and find the number between 1 and 5,000 and put it there, and then you may win a Focusrite solo. Again, I'm gonna run the contest until I hit 3,000 subscribers. Well, so as I said, we are gonna take a look to the setup of Kemper, audio interface, and software, Reaper in this case. And believe me, it's not as intuitive as you may think. So if you watch the video, it may save you a lot of hours of browsing the internet, because this is everything that the user manual will not tell you. Well, first of all, this is how my setup looks like. And it all runs through my iMac, which is a beast, right? It's a 32 giga RAM memory beast. You don't need to go that high, of course, but when you're managing different DAWs or whatever, it is always good to have plenty of RAM, because then you will not hear clippings, you can basically choose lower buffer sizes, etc, etc. Well, anyway, and then of course, if you look at the floor, the Kemper controller, right? Now, if we take a look to the back, is when the thing starts to get interesting. So let's take a look to the connections at the back. First of all, let's start with the Focusrite. You have your USB that goes to the USB of your computer, right? And you have here the line outs. You see two. I'm using line out one and line out two. And those are jack connection, right? A normal jack. But the monitors, in my case, my monitors, the iLoud have an RCA connection, which is this type of connection, right? So you will need to get yourself, if you're gonna use iLoud, by the way, I'm super happy with the iLouds, you will listen to them in the next videos, you will need to buy a cable that is jack to RCA, because this is the cable that comes with the iLoud, but goes to only one mini jack stereo for your computer, so it does not serve our purposes. Then, two cables, jack, RCA, that go from the Focusrite to your monitors. And now is when the thing starts to get interesting. You see here, in the Focusrite, I have taken this cable out. So you see that this is SPDIF, right? SPDIF. Well, this stands for Sony Philips Digital Interface, and is a connection that will allow you to record with digital quality. And the SPDIF is, in this case, is an RCA cable, but I bought a quality RCA cable. And then you will need to connect your in the Focusrite to your SPDIF out in your Kemper. And now we are gonna go to the Kemper, okay? So, you see in the left corner, SPDIF out of the Kemper to the SPDIF in of the Focusrite. Now, my Focusrite solo was not having SPDIF possibility. And why it is interesting to have SPDIF? Well, because as I said, it allows you to record with digital quality. It's amazing, and you will hear it in my videos moving forward. And then this is the reason why I took a step up to the Focusrite 6i6. Up to here, nothing that you won't be able to find in the user manual, but now comes the interesting part, is how the Kemper and the Focusrite are gonna understand each other now that they are connected. And believe me, that's the part that is not intuitive at all. No, for this part, I'm gonna need my screen. So you're running your Focusrite, and you have downloaded every single piece of software that comes with it. You have authorized all the apps, and among all the apps and among all the software, there is a very important application that comes with it. But first, you connect the Focusrite to your computer through the USB, and then you go and you open the Focusrite controller. And when you open it, you will see it says no hardware connected until it recognizes the Focusrite, which now it has that, Scarlett 6i6 connected. We get rid of this. And you go to device settings. And this is very, very important. You need to select the sample rate to 44.1 kHz because the Focusrite will come by default at 48. If you get it at 48, your Kemper and the Focusrite are not going to understand each other and you are not going to hear any single sound coming from your Kemper. And believe me, this is going to save you hours of searching on the internet. So 44.1, then the clocks of the Focusrite and the Kemper are going to understand each other. If you look here, sync, it says device is locked to a valid clock source. And the reason is very simple. Kemper is built in 44.1 kHz frequency and there's nothing else you can do. Then unless you synchronize both of them, Focusrite and Kemper, they are not going to understand each other, right? So once you have your device settings right, you go to mixing and routing. And this is also very important because it is how Focusrite kind of sends where Focusrite sends the inputs and where it selects the outputs, etc. So you have to think, about Focusrite like if it was a mixer, right? So this is my setup. Those are my settings. I'm gonna share them with you in a simple PowerPoint later. SPDIF 1 and 2, because I have chosen to record and to play digitally the Kemper through SPDIF. Analog 1 and 2, which is when I wanna run, where I'm gonna run my backing tracks. And then I have chosen to, as line output for my software here, though, as you see, software though, playback, the playback 1 and 2. And the way you can modify this is very simple. You see here there is a plus sign, and here you can add all the hardware inputs and all the line outputs that you want to add. That is the point. And in my next video, I'm gonna share with you how to do it through Reaper. In the meantime, I'm gonna leave you with a very simple PowerPoint in which I have explained my settings. Believe me, I think this is going to be very useful, mainly for the people who want to run Kemper in the digital domain through the SPDIF, because it is not very clearly explained at all in the user manual. And up to my next video, as always, play your guitars, have fun, and be good. Bye!